TWCL Grand Final Best of Seven Series starts right now. $1,750 on the line. The winner will not leave empty-handed. He will go home with, how much was it? $400, I guess? No, $650. That's also a nice boost to your bank account, I guess. So, yeah, focus here on the upper right. 26 years old from South Korea, of course. Living in Seoul now. He starts as the orc here. His way through the tournament was by far the best one. He comes from the winner bracket. He has, as we learned, a 1-0 advantage, which I will update right now. In this group stage, he beat Younger and Remind, two Night Elf players, 2-1. He advanced to the quarterfinal, beating Belief, went on facing Moon, and in the winner bracket final, he beat La Liot. So four times that he encountered Night Elf players, and he beat them all.
Yeah, he's performing very well. I saw the other day he was playing on Frenzy's stream, also against Korean Night Elf players, and they tried to use all fancy strats against him, but there's, at the moment, it seems like there's no chance of beating Focus with Night Elf. So he was able to beat Remind early on, he was able to beat Loliad, and yeah, he's doing very, very good for himself in that matchup. It's a hard matchup to figure out and actually understand what's going on there. I just experienced that myself when I was hitting ladder and just played random against Night Elf and got Orc, and sometimes you get just crushed by not understanding what you have to do or how the matchup works with all the mechanics. But this guy has figured it out all by himself, or just learned a big lesson from Fly, who was actually very, very good against Night Elf as well. So yeah, Focus, one of the guys who we definitely keep an eye on here, also for the Rust Brain Cup next week. I think he's also one of the contestants that might take that cup to his account. But today we're going to focus on the grand final. Best of seven, 1-0 lead here for our man. And yeah, both of them start with a typical normal build order.
My game is very, very laggy. I don't know if the same situation...
Same applies for me.
Okay, but I think it's stabilizing now, so it will be better the longer we cast. His opponent today is La Liot. Of course, this dude needs no introduction. The Master of the Warden, bronze medalist of WCA 2015, and the reigning and defending TWCL champion. His history in this cup... it's not that good as Focus's is, but his group stage, very easy. 2-0 versus Luna and Sock, who was also a named email fan back then. He advanced to the quarterfinal, beating Reprisal 2-1, semifinal 2-0 versus Lucifer, and then, obviously, the winner bracket final that he lost. The first series, actually, in a year that he lost against Focus, but he went on to the consolation final where he faced Moon in a best of seven already, and he beat him 4-3 in an epic, epic Night Elf Mirror best of seven. So yeah, maybe the favorite here, in my opinion at least, is La Liot, because yeah, 6-1 is pretty obvious here. But you see the first chop creep already, you see the big mana potion, and that's exactly what Last Refuge is good for the Orc. You can easily creep those shops, can easily get the Maggies and two big consumable items.
Yeah, the Magi is dropping also a lot of experience. Now he's selling the big mana potion because there's absolutely no use for that on the Blade Master early on. Could have maybe kept it for a second hero later, but the creeps activated, chasing away the Demon Hunter, and now Focus will also get the Boots of Speed on his shop here. So he's quite well equipped, to say the least. He got a Claws of Attack plus 6 from the green spot, then he got a Circlet, and now he got the Boots of Speed with the Dust of Appearance. But since we don't really see any archers on the field, that's really not playing a huge role here. He just gets that to maybe deny it from his opponent or kill that one single archer that Night Elf players like to get. Focus, on the other hand, taking to tier 2, 75% done already. Two Grunts are on the field, blocking the entrance towards his main base. Third Burrow will go up without any trouble, and so far he's securing himself a very nice position in that game. Yeah.
I would totally agree, of course. Keeping the base closed, one of the most important things in this matchup. You don't want the Demon Hunter to enter that base. You don't want him to cancel your tier 2 buildings. You don't want him to cancel the burrows. And so far, as you mentioned, Focus is doing a great job. I do not agree with selling the big mana potion, to be honest. I think it's just the perfect item for the Tauren Chieftain. You can do so much damage with it. And what do you use the gold for now? I mean, you are in tech, you will have the resources for the tier 2 buildings. I'm not so sure.
Yeah, sometimes it's really weird. I also saw, like, who was it yesterday who was selling Sobei Mask? Ah, I was actually watching Todd's stream, and he was selling Sobei Mask like 3 times in a row. And I was like, dude, this is one of the best items that you can possibly find. and he's just selling it. But yeah, selling big mana potions is also something that, I don't know, for some reason people tend to like to have these kind of early advantages and not really think of the bigger picture of like on a level 3 TC, getting that potion will be sick. Now Demon Hunter creeping the Augur Magi on the other side of the map, the Goblin Merchant off focus without too much trouble here. Demon Hunter still has to be careful, there's a step of teleportation, but the Beastmaster finds himself a nice big invo potion, and the Blademaster, too bad for focus, is coming from the wrong side here, could have forced maybe a town portal on the opponent. But yeah, he also sold the replenishment potion that I don't really understand, because the amount of gold that you get for the replenishment potion is not as high. He sold it at the shop. Town is under siege. Lolite is using it by focus earlier.
Ah, focus, you're talking about focus, alright.
And he sold it, so I don't really understand. I think it's one of the best things you can have.
On a Blademaster for sure, because the healing if you're in Windwalk cannot be cancelled. But here's the Torrent Chieftain, the Blademaster's still level 2. Usually you want him at level 3 to be able to roam around, annoy the Shiat out of the Night Elf. But not today. He's gonna help his Torrent Chieftain fill up to creep up to level 3. Both Night Elf heroes creeping as well. So this is the change in meta game that we saw recently, that the Beastmaster not harassing anymore, not trying to get the buildings. But okay, he sent in the Quill Beast, which has expired now. And so the Step of Teleportation in the Demon Hunter's inventory has not been put to good use yet.
No, but sooner or later he will use it when he got the Staff of Preservation on the other hero, so that he can staff in and out. That's pretty good. He is actually preparing for the late game. Maybe if he is forced to use it in the earlier stages, he will do it. One peon is hanging around the expansion and is actually waiting for the amount of wood to throw down that expo. He's researching Ensnare and the Adept Train upgrade for the Spirit Walkers, so he's doing a fair job here. Blademaster not level 3 yet, but on a good way, and TC will hit level 2 by finishing the creeps here at the Goblin Merchant, while the Knight of Player will actually creep with his Ancient of War here. Oh no, he lets go of it and will be on the aggressive, is cancelling the expansion with that Staff of Teleportation on the Quill Beast, so great job there from Reliant.
Yeah, that scouting was absolutely on point, very very well done by Lolight. Here's the Tinker, the obvious third hero for the Pocket Factory later on. So I think the volume is better now. Please tell me about it in chat. Thank you, Remo, for letting me know. There's not too many talents on the battlefield. He just started his master training, so that's the perfect time for focus to hit. He picks up the first one with an Ensnare, but of course he fights against the Moonwells, and it's not that easy.
Yeah, it's very odd, because at some point you think you might have an advantage, but this advantage might fade. Now a nice kill here on the tail end. The wave is not hitting all that much, but it's only a level 1 wave. He's distracting him, so Focus has... Maybe Focus can creep that mercenary, would be really risky, but he's at least forcing his opponent to stay inside his main base, and this gives him some more time, some more momentum to gather some more forces and find some more experience for the TC, especially to get an up to level 3. Now gathering all his units to dispel them with one dispel off that Spirit Walker, so no more Fairy Fire on the units. PNN position for the expo, but so far not letting it, like, not throwing it down.
Yeah, Focus was a little late with his Orc-Burrow. Of course, he wanted the expansion to come through, so he was supply stuck for a little while. We have 38 versus 40 food now. First staff being used to save that talent. I think the position is quite okay for Lolite, but he keeps on losing two talents here in the upper edge of his main base. Demon Hunter now in problems, but oh, one more Ensnare is here, but he loses the one grunt in return. Or will he? Yes, he does. So nice defense by Lolite here.
Yeah, but this push is not designed to kill you. This push is just designed to kill a few talents, get a little bit of experience. If you don't lose too many units in return, it's definitely good. The Spirit Walker has to stay alive, then I think he might be in a good position. The Cluster Rockets here from the Tinker. He's not even going for the Pocket Factory. Cluster Rockets level 1 here. The Raiders are streaming in on the Talons, killing yet another one. Beastmaster dropping low. TC is getting a heal scroll most likely. 400 gold on the bank account. Few units still low, Grunt dies, two Raiders are in the orange HP, have to be very very careful. He's focusing the Beastmaster, nonetheless there is still talent and Master upgrade kicking in, so that hero is in the air for the entire fight. He loses another Raider, expansion has started, but this is not looking all that good for Mr. Focus.
Nah, he lost a lot here. He bought the heal scroll, had to use it immediately, so Lalai definitely stabilizing. Once that Cyclone kicks in, the matchup turns around and the Night Elf is heavily favored, but okay, the expansion halfway through, but two Quillbees sent at the same time. Will they be able to do enough damage to cancel it? I doubt it, because one of them is about to expire, but of course, with a triple hero force, he's very close by, and he will just right-click, and Focus has to cancel it for the second time. He tries to intervene here, but too late.
Yeah, too late. The amount of mana on the tail end is not that scary. Actually, only get a few more cyclones. But the heroes, also without the Orb of Venom, he might be able to fend that one off. Has to be careful with that Spirit Walker. Has to morph it. Or it will be killed from the other side from that Quillbeast. Yep, losing that one. A little bit of a poor micro there from Focus. We're not used to see that of him. One tail end will be killed here by the unit. Cyclone on that Blade Master. Rockets are hitting the units. Keep in mind, the Factor is usually there to, like, have a little bit of a better spot and get some more damage on the field. So without that Pocket Factory, I think he might be in trouble, but the number of Raiders is not that impressive. Mana burn on the Walker. Blademaster tries to focus the Demon Hunter. There's still several preservation, and he dies to a critical strike. And now he's going for the second hero, Talpaul, being used on that Beastmaster, and he steps out. But there's no more Demon Hunter on the field for quite some time.
Exactly, he did not see that critical strike coming. Otherwise, he would have transferred the town portal, I guess, but he wasn't fast enough, so Focus now. Maybe finally the time to get his expansion up. He tries it for the third time, and you know what they say, all good things come in threes. The Blade Master is still a beast, though, plus 10 damage. He has good shop control, stealing the heal scrolls from the Night Elf shop. So the shockwave will hit him hard, and Lolite has to defend now without mana burn. How's the mana count on the TC? Very, very low. No mana potion on him as well. No resources for that. Nice end snare, but Cyclone buys a little more time. The Demon Hunter is 50% back. How much dispel is there? One, two dispels maybe.
And to be honest, I don't get the rockets. I don't like it at all, but yeah. Let's see how this fight continues here. He's fighting inside the main base of the Night Elf player. There's not a lot of juice back, but you can see the TC is dropping fairly low. Can he transfer that
Invo potion?
He's healing, with the heal scroll here, but the TC is still surrounded. So if he's only able to give that Invo potion to the TC, he might be in a very, very good spot. Doing that right now, you said it. The Beastmaster is down. Demon Hunter coming back. But the units are dwindling here for the Night Elf player. And the fight inside the Night Elf main base seems to be a very, very good one for the Orc player here.
Yeah, he forced the issue while the Demon Hunter was away. Capitalized with a second hero kill. And all of a sudden, while Lolayat fought him off two times already, this third time didn't look too well for him. The expansion, two-thirds are done. And what can he accomplish here? Almost level 4 Blade Master, level 3 Tauren Chieftain. All he needs is some items from the shop, and then he'll be good to kill off the Night Elf army. 47 food for Lolayat, that is pretty good. Hearthstone, also a nice one. Only 46 food for Focus. Usually that's not enough. Usually you want 10 food more than your Night Elf opponent. But if you have an expansion in your bag, that can definitely work.
Yeah, but so far the very aggressive style here from Focus is paying off so well. It's crazy. He's forcing fight after fight on his Night Elf opponent. And even though that Lolayat seems to have a huge army with a lot of mana on their tail ends, he's not able to take the fights convincingly. Now selling one of the circlets is getting the Orb of Venom finally on his first hero. Level 3 for the Demon Hunter, level 2 mana burn will decrease the mana of the TC by quite a huge margin. There's the Book of the Dead that might be very useful as long as there's no Wisp on the field, but he could also just sell it and get a mana potion for that. I like that he keeps it and that he will take the fight close to his Expo, course. He's kind of forced to go there now, Lolayat. He's bringing two Wisps, so he might be aware of the fact that there is a Book of Dead, or he just wants to bring them for the Detonate on the Spirit Link. Yeah, it's looking good for the Orc player if he can take that fight close to his Expo.
Definitely, Lolayat knows that the clock is ticking against him. He goes in with Fury Dragons and Talents now. No level 3 Beastmaster. That is definitely not the level he wants to have. At least he has the Hawk. At least the Blade Master is scouted. Here comes the first Shockwave, and everything is lined up. Awesome start for Focus into the fight. But yeah, I think the Walkers are a little bit too offensive here. Next Shockwave! Oh my god, what a beauty of a spell this is! Book of the Dead being used. Demon Hunter is surrounded. Can he find out that the Tinker is dead? The next target might be the Beastmaster as well. He's pretty damn low. No items on him anymore. There is the Hearthstone, but I think he has to use it. Yes, on the Demon Hunter. Doing that now. Everything is high up in the air for focus, and the talents don't seem to do the job.
Yeah, talents focusing the spirit walkers here. They die. There's still one alive, but all that cyclone is
Demon.
Not keeping him in the game. GG.
Demon Hunter died after that surround, and he wins the first map. Focus does pretty convincingly, to be honest. There was some struggles in the mid game, but he came back so damn strong.
It's so crazy to see how these guys are actually playing, because Focus seems to, like I said it before, he seems to figure out, or he figured out that matchup, like every single detail. Like some people might say he fights with tier with level 2 DTC and there's no chance of like getting into late game and stuff, but then he pulls off these fights, kills a few talents with every fight, loses a few units in exchange, but somehow he gets the better traits. No Orb of Venom on the Demon Hunter for a long time, level 2 Demon Hunter also for a long time, killing the first hero. And I don't know, overall it was just a mess for Lulayat, but it's due to the fact that Focus plays so aggressive and is forcing the issue, like every single one, every single fight was on top. It was so crazy.
So this is a 2-0 lead now for the Orc, and it's of course the winner. The guy wins who gets 4 maps, so Focus has to win 2, Lulayat has to win 4, and things getting very, very dicey here for the Night Elf. But maybe Last Refuge, we talked about this, was an okay Orc map. Maybe now we see a map where the Night Elf shine.
Yeah, I think we saw the Vetoes earlier, right? I think Nomad Ides is out of the pool and...
I can't really remember.
Where is it? Where is it? I tried to find it. I think Nomad Ides got vetoed by Lulayat.
And... that shouldn't be the only veto, right?
No, there was also one veto from Focus, so the map pool is bigger than I thought. I thought it's only seven maps, but it seems to be like 9 maps in total.
Okay.
So let's see, second map will be Ancient Isles, and this is a pretty good map for Nida. Of course, there are not too many creeps, but that you can actually creep without getting a lot of damage on all of your units. The Poison Creep for the natural expansion, also the shops, they are not that well protected, but on the end they also do a lot of damage with two of the Berserkers, and the Red Spot is also like heavily stacked with Poison units. So at some point, if you creep that and you get creep checked in a bad spot, can deal quite some damage, can kill a few units there. But the yellow color is superior, and I like that. Yellow against red, we're gonna see it tonight as well. And yeah, Borussia Dortmund against Liverpool will be a great match as well.
Return of Kloppo. Would be nice if that would be a best of seven. But map number 2 is starting. And here we go, everybody. Ancient Isles it is. 2-0 lead for the newlywed, who came through the winner bracket. He's starting in the bottom right, the WCG bronze medalist of 2013, fighting the bronze medalist of WCA 2015. These are good friends. Lulayat did attend his wedding, of course, as well as the other guys. Blue Tail, shout out to you, and the other Korean pro gamer friends out there. So, yeah, still, this is not a friendly match. This is a final for $1,750. And I think you can live with that for a bit. So in the upper left, it's Lulayat.
Have you ever thought about that these guys might be splitting?
Yes, but I didn't want to mention it.
Okay, now it's out. I'm there for the real talk. But nonetheless, like best of seven. Right now, 2-0 for Focus, so if he wins one more map, we're gonna have match ball from there on. And yeah, that might be a very, very confident, like, he can really play, like, all crazy strats then. He can pull out, like, tier 1 tower rushes, he can try to go for Blademaster Naga. I'm not really sure if his portfolio of strategies is all that big, because I don't really see him toy around with crazy strats. But I think if he got some in his pocket, he should definitely use it if he got, like, a 2-0 advantage or 3-0 advantage.
Yeah. Just for the lulz, I saw him play Blademaster and Naga. So if he gets an advantage in the early game by, I don't know, killing a few archers, forcing the town portal on the Demon Hunter, whatsoever, then I can see that from Focus. But yeah, especially on this map, but not too much. Of course, he's starting things with a Blademaster, his opponent Demon Hunter first. Demon Hunter will get very, very close to level 2 by the Ogre Magi here. And the Orc has 2... he can go for creep as well at the orange spot, or he goes for immediate harass.
Yeah, but since he's not getting a Voodoo launch right now and skipping his second Burrow, this indicates that he will have a super fast tier 2 tech. And with that, he will most likely transition into either dual Bestiary Raider or even some crazy Wyvern strategy. But I usually see Focus go for this one Burrow tech without the shop and then throw down the second Burrow. Yep, there it is. So normal kind of build that he likes to do with a little bit of a fast attack to throw off the Night Elf timing for the second hero for the Beastmaster. Because you can see the tech is now started for Night Elf player, not even started. Now Blademaster will get hold of that archer. Is he able to kill that one? Yes, he is. Nice backstep damage from the Windwalk. Now even using the next Windwalk, not mana burned by Luliad. I think this was definitely a mistake by him. Could have mana burned that Blademaster and kept him on another Windwalk. But yeah, it looks still good here for Focus in the second game of the series that we are seeing here. Tech is started for Luliad and all the Wisp are in very, very good positions. So look at this beautiful Wisp hiding. This is trademark Moon almost.
Yeah, can't be attacked. Everywhere around the map is some wisps, and in the base they can't be attacked because the trees are in front of that. I guess that's what they're talking about now as well. But unfortunately, we can't read or understand it, so we don't know what they're saying. Tier 2 tech for Focus as well. You explained it. Third Burrow is coming, the shop is coming, and the first heroes are battling each other at least a bit. Town portal still not being sold, and now it's time to battle for the boots.
The run for the boots is going on. It will be there at 7. Right now it's 6:40. He's basically waiting. He's laying down the items to the ground. You can really see that these guys are best, or not best buddies necessarily, but definitely good buddies. They're going to enter the door real quick. I think there's a package coming right now.
All right. So the Blademaster got the boots, and he won that first little battle of the game, and he comes in at a nice timing, two moon worlds in the process, but he blocks with a wisp for now, getting a little split second out of this, but he might be able to cancel that, so Luliad will not be supply stuck or whatever, but that's of course healing that you want to have. Repair is coming and the moon well finishes. Three wisps will do the job, four wisps of course even better, and techs are about to be done, and the base is open, so he can't enter with the Demon Hunter. He has a staff. No Beastmaster, though. That is very interesting. That could have supported his attack here. But alright, he's going for the Peons. He blocks, of course, the surface for the Tier 2 building, so that will be delayed. And the Demon Hunter, with one more Peon kill, will have level 2. And then finally, Evasion. Or did we see Mana Burn yet?
I think we haven't seen Mana Burn yet, or I think he might have done a mistake by skilling Evasion, but I don't see misses coming out, so it's kind of odd. Do you have the tool on? I think you can use it on Bennett, right?
Not working on 1.27.
So bad. I would like to see the skill, because it's kind of odd. He was not using Mana Burn earlier, and he's not using it. Yeah, we haven't seen it in the entire game. ... from Focus, not sure what this is about, but yeah, they're not necessarily best buddies. They definitely have a connection. Of course, we saw them WCA, and they were like good friends hanging out with each other the entire time. Not only because they were Koreans, but they really had some bonding going on. Because Reprisal, on the other hand, also a Korean, he was not really part of that gig, like not the entire time. Of course, he was hanging out with the Koreans, but Focus and Luliad, they were like definitely friends at least.
Yeah, that's for sure. They hung around with Moon as well, so these three were definitely on a good connection to each other. So, enter the winds are coming. Tier 3 tech already started for Luliad. Of course, you want that Cyclone as fast as possible. Now we have the Torrent Chieftain for Focus, and still no second hero for Luliad. There it is.
There it is.
Very, very late, in my opinion.
It's actually kind of late, but he prefers to have his fast attack here, so he's also messing with his opponent's timings. Because last time you saw that Focus was attacking the main base of Luliad when he just started the Master Talon upgrade, and this time he might have an advantage. And yes, he actually got evasion on that hero. There is no mana burn. We saw a lot of misses from all the grunts here, and he misskilled it on level 1 because he thought he might close in on level 2 really fast, and he's stuck on evasion. He only got the passive skill on his first hero, and this is what makes this game a little bit odd at least. Trying to go for the TC, not able to kill that one, and now has to retreat with the Beastmaster as well. Ensnare still being researched, so he cannot really go for any kind of crazy surrounds here, but sooner or later it will be done, and then Luliad has to be really, really, really careful.
Indeed, the game for Focus went totally all right, except the fact that his tier 2 buildings are a little delayed. No creeping so far on the Torrent Chieftain. He shows a lot of map presence. He's hanging around the tavern, trying the Knight off to, I don't know, catch his Tinker off guard or something, catch a Hero off guard. And Snare might be there in a second as we see the Raider position himself. There it is. The first net being thrown, and he goes on to the Beastmaster immediately. The staff is on the second tier, now being transferred and now being staffed out to save him. And I guess that's the time now to creep to at least level 2. But of course he has to be aware that the Orc is hiding around the corner.
Yeah, Orc is just creeping right in front of his doorstep here, going for that little camp. But the Blade Master also almost zero experience so far in that game. He definitely has to gather some XP for both of his heroes. So far he was doing quite a good job against the Night Elf, who was sitting tight and all passive with that Demon Hunter. Tried to do the best that he can, but in the end not really succeeding in doing anything. Master Talent upgrade started. 25 to 30% done already. So the tier 3 upgrade is kicking in soon. Is there Orb of Venom yet? Nope, he didn't get that one. He's approaching the tavern, so he might go for the third hero really, really quick. Two peons, four peons are coming here in total, joining the army of the Orc player. And it looks like that Focus will try to go for the same push that he used on Last Refuge, but this time he's even pulling the peons and just provides some more, like, concave area, but also draining a lot of mana. If you don't disable that fairy fire, you also cast it on the peons.
That's right, and he found the Wand of Illusion, so more targets for the Spirit Link that boosts up the HP pool that Spirit Link is benefiting from. But here comes Laliad into the main base of Focus, trying to get rid of the Orc Burrows, trying to get him supply stuck to build a nice Talon army. But the same is going on for Focus. He's going for the Moonwells here. Nice shockwave, but not too much, obviously. Level 2 for both heroes here. First Moonwell is down, the shop is down, so no Orb of Venom. In the other side here, two burrows cancel, the third one being killed as well. So Focus will be supply stuck for a long, long time.
Yeah, same deal for the other player. Laliad is also getting his Moonwells tracked, so he tries to get a few more Moonwells in the back of his main base. He's getting a few more Talons, cycling that Blade Master. Another Moonwell is being attacked, and both of the players are actually killing the very same buildings in the opponent's main base. Now chasing away the gold line here, so this is the main difference right now. While Focus is not mining at all, Laliad is still mining gold from that entangled gold mine. So in the end, it might be a better trade for the Night Elf player, but he cannot really afford to lose his production buildings, and this is the reason why he's townpalling in. There's a Voodoo Launch close by. All of the heroes are there. This might be the last fight of the second map that we are going to see. Grunt dies immediately. Cyclone on that Blade Master. TC is being mana burned. There's still a heal scroll on that hero. Wave is not hitting anything there. Bad wave there from Focus. His second hero is dropping down as well. Has to be careful. Uses the healing scroll right away. Now focusing that tiny pocket hall. But in the end, is he able to take the fight? It's not looking good for him.
Beast mode enabled on the Blade Master. He's going for the first hero again. That saved him the game. On map number one, or two, to be honest, he's going for. There's no shop, mind you, but the raiders are dwindling. He's hiding behind his Tree of Eternity, who's a big right hitter, or big right hander, to be honest. And yeah, now both players are supply stuck, but Laliad is still on 40 food, and Focus is down to 30. Usually, you want that advantage, that food advantage as an orc. This is completely impossible. Focus with proxy burrows to hide him from his main base, but he's still not mining at all. He's not rebuilding peons, only now, so maybe a little overwhelmed with what just happened in the Night Elf base.
Yeah, he couldn't really retreat because there was no town portal on the Orc player. So the moment the Night Elf was just like bypassing him on the map and was entering his main base, there was no choice. He could not really go back. If he's running back, he's losing too much without dealing any damage. If he stays there, you just saw what happened. He was able to kill a few of these Moonwells, but since Laliad was mining the entire time while that attack was approaching his main base, it didn't really do all that much damage.
That level 2.5 Blade Master, level 2 Torrent Chieftain. No items except this one Invul potion that he, of course, needs against the Cyclone. Maybe he can steal the red spot, but of course, it's dangerous. But here's a scout with the illusion, so he knows when his opponent is making his way into the east. Warlord is down, Hearthstone again.
Look how Lulite is trolling his opponent. He just bought a Zepper while he's creeping there. Because there was a Wisp close by, now the Zepper dies to the unit. He's really trolling Focus here in that game because he knows in what kind of a good position he is for the second map. Buying the Zepper. Just for the lads.
Maybe he is overconfident here. I'm not too sure. He has a heal scroll now. No invul potion and no town portal. Only a step of teleportation and a step of preservation. And snare immediately on the demon. Blade Master in beast mode already. But he will be cycled in a second. There is a heal scroll. He has to use it soon. Nice shockwave. And now, heal scroll being used, but Cyclone is in full effect. One grunt is down. The second raider kills the pocket factory. So that's a leak of damage, but he gets surrounded, picked up. Level 2 on the Tinker. He's leveling so crazy. And that is the 2-1. Lolliot is taking Ancient Isles home.
That's my boy. Trolling with the Zapper, securing the victory. Playing a splendid game here on the second map, just with the better choices when it comes down to attacking his opponent's main base. And yeah, not defending on the other hand. That was a pretty good choice that he made, realizing that Focus doesn't have a town portal. I like. So we have a 2-1 score in favor of Focus still, right?
Yeah, that's correct.
So we are basically down to a best... No, it's actually not a best of 5. It's a best of 3 still for Focus. If he's able to win 2 more maps, he will be able to take the $1,650, right? $1,074 it actually is.
Exactly.
So this is some serious money. We spoke about that, but so far both of the players looking convincingly on the maps. Like first map last year, it's very good for Focus. Yeah. Now Lolliot coming back with a splendid second game here. Looking forward to see how this continues. Almost reminds me of last week, Lolliot against Moon. We saw like really cool games coming out of Lolliot, then Moon countering it, coming back into that game. And yeah, this was a very cool best of 7 series that we saw in A Night of Mirror, not expecting it at all. So in case you missed it, definitely check out the YouTube, Back to Warcraft, and follow these VODs. It's just amazing to see these guys play.
Especially if you think that Night of Mirror is boring, that's definitely the games for you. Next map is gonna be Turtle Rock. And I think that is a very, very good map for the Tauren Chieftain, because the units will all be piled up. It's gonna be very narrow positions, and there's not too much the Night Elf can do against it, I guess. I mean, the shops basically belong to the Blade Master, especially with the new Chinese creeps trick that we know, but of course a lot comes down to starting positions. I mean, if we have a close position, then it definitely favors the Night Elf.
That's actually true, but close position will be possible. Yeah, it's the Blizzard map, so close position is definitely possible. And close position, as we know it from the past and from the games we casted, it's the most entertaining scenario, to say the least. Because we saw Ancient of Wars marching from one side to another with a lot of archers. We saw crazy tower rushes, catapults, cutting down trees, planting towers behind the trees towards the main base of the Night Elf and stuff like that. And yeah, I think you mentioned that Focus was the guy who created crazy games with tier 3 Orc here on Turtle Rock.
One of my favorite games of all time, Focus versus Moon, Intel Extreme Masters 2009. Oh boy, that was a game for the ages. But we are here, and I think this will be a lot more standard than we saw it before. It's cross positions, so no close spawn. And that opens up the opportunity to get to the shops really, really quick. Get that watch award and a lot of map vision here. Lolliot as the Red Night Elf spawning in the bottom right, or in the upper right. Lolliot spawning in the lower left of Turtle Rock.
True, true. So far, the both of the players start with the normal, typical build orders that Ancient of War on the right side of his main base to not reveal his position and not for the peon to be able to pull the turtles towards that Ancient of War to probably cancel it if there would be an early scout from Focus. We don't even see that early scout coming out here from the yellow orc player. But yeah, sometimes it's really cool to just have it on the other side and throw your opponent a little bit off, because not expecting it. Because sometimes if you don't see it in the normal position, you think like, maybe he's skipping it, going for Huntresses, but it's just on the other side, a little bit hidden. Demon Hunter as a first hero here for the Night Elf player, and Blade Master coming for Focus yet again.
Of course, those hero choices are not discussable in this, I guess. Maybe if Farseer once or twice in a few years, but that's about it. Blade Master pretty much the standard hero to go for the hero kills later on. Shop is in time, and the Engine of War is finished, producing the first archer to assist him in the creep. But apart from that, everything looks in order here. And yeah, Nidalee versus Orc, definitely a matchup which is not too excited in the early games, in the early stages of the game, but tier 3 definitely does the job and has a lot of action for us.
Yeah, and since this is a grand final, there will not be too much of shenanigans going on between the players, like in terms of strategies, I think. I was actually looking forward to see some crazy strats. We haven't really seen any of that so far. I'm not expecting it because both of the players are kind of the typical standard guys. Focus really likes the standard strategies. Loliath, he was playing crazy strats against Moon, but this might be only for the Orc against, or Night Elf against Night Elf mirror match, where he used like Hippogriffs, for example, or Hippo Riders. That was pretty damn cool. And yeah, let's see. Focus is going for the Ogre Magi here, right off the bat, starting with that one. This is the Focus Creep, so-called. He's getting that circlet by selling his Town Portal and is now finishing that one off. Two of the Ogres are not even attacking him. This is the whole reason why you can pull that one off without taking too much damage. Boots of Speed for him, so he doesn't even have to buy that one. I think it's definitely one of the good items. The Wisp block here on the creeps failed a little bit. One of the Ogre Warriors went back to the creep spot, now finally being cleared by Loliath. And this time, I'm not sure, did he go for mana burn? I think he did, because I never saw a miss sign going up. So this time level 1 mana burn, not risking it to never reach level 2 and not having a mana burn for a long run. Yeah, first game, in the end he was able to win that one, even though he had evasion for quite a long time.
Yeah, might have been the case that he went for evasion here as well, because he didn't expect the Blade Master, so you don't really need it, since the creeps don't have mana to do damage on them. So I can see evasion work as level 1 here. Of course, on the prior map, that is another case, because there's an Ogre Magi, which you can burn. So yeah, the task force now for the Blade Master is to creep as many spots as possible, to gather a lot of claws and circlets, boost your damage up, try to annoy the Night Elf a bit, and we have a Gloves of Haste, not that great. A little scouting with grunts here, tier 2 techs obviously have started for both players, and Focus has a huge tech advantage.
Yeah, his Blade Master is called Mikasa Isukasa, so the Demon Hunter is actually making use of that and is going inside that main base of the Orc player, trying to at least kill a few or put a lot of damage on the peons here. We saw that in a previous series, not sure if you saw the matches, but Focus was losing his Blade Master while he was trying to fend off the push of the Demon Hunter inside his main base. Now going for the Ogre Magic kill on the other side, not sure what the item was, but
second
he definitely sold the
second pair of boots.
Second pair of boots, yeah, definitely not worth. So the Jordans go to the shop and they are back on the Blade Master. Nonetheless, the Grunt is being Antoinette healed up, and the Demon Hunter in the meantime is still standing strong inside that main base.
Yeah, and he just killed a Grunt.
He does kill the Grunt, yeah, what the hell?
He did kill a Grunt, so Loliath's Arras is working flawlessly so far. He can easily walk back into his base. So here comes the Blade Master with boots versus no boots. How much mana is there? Oh, another Wind Walk. Mana burn now, but he used it before. Backstep damage is coming in, and he can get more right clicks because he has more movement speed. Does he have to sacrifice himself into the creeps? Block attempt with the Grunt, but not nailing it. Oh boy, this is gonna be so close. Two more hits from the Blade Master. He misses one! And he's getting closer and closer.
Finishing up in time! And the tier 2 tech is about to finish. Maybe he can buy a potion.
No, he's not even
going for it. He's going long distance. He wants to go inside the main base. Archer is coming to rescue the Demon Hunter. Wow. And he succeeds.
Wow, what a nice play by Loliath. Ballsy move to not wait for the shop. He could have run around in circles on that and distract the Blade Master a bit to get to the potion. But of course, Moon Juice is a little cheaper. And that's why it was preferred by Loliath. Dancing around the Blade Master with 20 HP is a thing you can do if you have the confidence. And of course, the evasion, that helped. We saw it in the Europe versus Korea clan war, how good evasion can be. Poor Czechy. But yeah, the Torrent Chieftain level tier 2 hero for the Orc. We have Beastry, we have Spirit Lodge, we have basically everything. But what we didn't mention, Focus got both shops, so he knows exactly when Loliath is gonna go and buy items.
Yeah, but Loliath will never buy items. He is super aggressive here, hyper aggressive to say the least. Now putting that archer there, is there dust? Actually, there is dust. He would have been locked inside his main base for a long time. But this is very, very well done there. No staff of teleportation on the Demon Hunter, so he can staff him out, but not staff him in again. Beastmaster staffing his first hero body out. Demon Hunter goes to the main base. He juices up and just starts running toward the Orc base again. Ancient of Winds are finally done inside the main base. Tier 3 tech, of course, started. Standard game plan from Loliath putting into play here. The Talons, the Adept Train is started as well. So three Quilbies try to be annoying and try to get some more time from his opponent here, trying to go and force the peons inside the Boros by attacking them. Is he able to kill that one of the peons? Nope, he's not. It's in the Boro in time. Demon Hunter, where is he, by the way? There he is. Mana burning the TC. Has to be careful. Maybe he can step out the... Nice block from the Raider, almost preventing that step exchange to the first hero. The micro is real, though.
It was very, very close. So Turtle Rock, a very action-packed game right from the early mid-game. Beastmaster healed up a bit, but maybe he wants to get some items, so he went back. Loses a little bit of time. Oh, now End Snare, but he misses the crit! Unfortunate for Focus. He's not that lucky with his hits here. Or, on the other side, Lolliot is lucky with his dodges. In the meantime, the Quilby is still harassing a little bit, but the production is, of course, uncontested. Here comes another Ant Snare. Maybe he's luckier this time. No crit so far, but here comes the block from the Raider. It's getting dicey. Where's the staff? Transfers it now and gets his first tier out alive.
Balls of Steel. Not even thinking about using that town portal, just giving it over to the other hero, staffing him out in the very last second. And that Ancient of Wonders of the middle made it to the main base. Or did he build another one and lost the one? I don't think so, right?
I think he walked back.
Because that Ancient of Wonders was in the middle of the map and now it's inside that map. Ancient of War all of a sudden starts on the turtles because it was day and they were awake. Now being destroyed by the orc player, denying him the creeping without taking any damage. But the Talons are already in field. Nice block here from the Demon Hunter on the Blade Master. Can he finish that one off? Nope, he escapes. He got the nice movement speed from the Boots of Speed and with that he will be able to retreat.
Exactly, but the problem, or the long-term problem for Focus, is only 20 experience on his Tauren Chieftain. Well, we have a triple hero combo for the Night Elf, level 2-1-1 here. I don't know, he needs that area of effect damage. Without that, he's kind of lost in the fights, in the big fights, obviously. But his army is kind of looking good, 46 food, he has a little lumber issues, but he's still pulling the peons to the fight. He knows, okay, Night Elf might be superior at the moment, so I need that kind of, that little help, that little meat shield to save.
I would be very surprised if he went for the cluster rockets again as the first spell on that team.
No, I think we will see the pocket factory for sure.
But I like Hololight is trolling sometimes with his spells and units and whatever he's doing.
So here we go into the fight. Cyclone immediately used, so that one is finished as well. The Raiders find the surface on the Talons to do heavy, heavy damage. I don't know, yeah, that needs repositioning here. I guess the fight starts good for Focus. First Talon is down, Lotus ensnared. The heroes on the ground at the moment. Windwalk being used. He's going for the Demon Hunter once again. To one crit and two misses here. Evasion is really doing the job for the Demon Hunter this game.
I'm not really sure about the focus of Lolliot. He's paying a lot of attention to the Spirit Walks. Now his first hero is surrounded. There's still Steph of Evasion on the Beastmaster. Now focusing the TC on the other hand. That is still level 1, so not such a big of a kill, to be honest. In the meantime, he's not paying attention to the Raiders. The Raiders have pretty much free reign over the Knight of Army here. Now they are all on the ground. None of them is Cycloned. And finally, he's able to kill one of the Talons. He's going on more here, but the healing potion on the TC should keep him alive for now. Blademaster still standing strong. Is there mana for more Cyclone? Nope, not a single one. Oh, the new one that just came to the fight. He got enough mana for a Cyclone, but the rest can definitely take a good fight here. Demon Hunter got the town portal from the Beastmaster. Is town portaling out? And I think the exchanges were very good for Lolliot, but I still don't understand why he would go and snipe the Spirit Walkers as a first target here in the fight. Usually the Demon Hunter is doing a very, very good DPS against the Raiders, but he's not even paying attention to the Raiders. He ignores them, goes for the Spirit Walkers and Cyclones the heroes. So a little bit of a different approach that I see that from what I see from other Night Elf players.
Yeah, Focus definitely saved a lot. Well, it makes sense to focus the walkers if you're in a position for that. Of course, if they're placed defensively, then running across the orc army does not make so much sense. But yeah, it kinda paid off in the end. So without Dispel and without more Link, of course, it makes things a little easier. Both players are going for the red spots. They want their hero levels. They want the big items that you can find the top and the tail of the turtle. Claws plus 12. On the Demon Hunter, that's a huge boost. On the other side.
Pretty legit plus 22 damage now on that first hero.
Easy.
If he decides to go for some Raiders, he can definitely kill them without too much trouble. Healing Rune is always nice to have. If you kill that Ogre Magi, it drops on the ground and you can use it on all the units and heroes. I think it's basically like a heal scroll for free.
Yeah, I think so too.
So let's see if Focus is lucky and gets a better item like Unholy Aura or Vampiric Aura or Mana Aura would be fantastic as well.
Yeah, and of course Claws plus 12, also a nice addition to the Blade Master. We see it right now. Crystal Ball. Ooh, that is a horrible outcome. And this time, it's Lolliot building the expansion. He knows, alright, first fight went good, the item is great, the creeping goes on. So why not back it up with an expansion? As a Night Ops, you can easily do that, obviously. Demon Hunter is missing at the moment. There won't be any burns. Focus seems to be engaging here. 50 food versus 50. The end snare is the end snares are flying. The Demon Hunter is coming back into the game.
Yeah, and for this fight, I think the Blade Master will be in the air for the rest of the fight. And he's preventing that going for the Blade Beast Master and now forcing the Town Portal.
Ooh boy.
That was super close.
He has his hands on the button, on the trigger of the Town Portal, but once again, Focus is draining gold from his opponent's bank account. Blade Master, is he scouting the expo? He looks at the shop and he sees, all right, there's nothing here, but he gets the invo potion. Good shop control by Focus, of course. It's a little easier when you have watch awards there. Now he scouts it, now he sees the Tree of Life, and he will cancel it immediately, destroying Lolliot's game plan. A player's forces are under
attack. Yeah, that was very important that he actually get hold of the expo and cancels it before it's up, because it's a whole lot harder to cancel that one when it's finally done, and you have to, like, put a lot of radius to it to actually kill it. But this gives Lolliot the time that he needs to get his second and third hero maybe up to level 3 before the next fight, and this is also really, really crucial. Level 2 Pocket Factory is very strong, level 2 Quillbeast are very strong as well. Demon Hunter is going here to sell that Wand of Mana Stealing to maybe get himself an Invo Potion and a Heal Scroll. But of course, Focus will see it, because you said it, there is a Watch Award from the early game, and whenever you go to the shop, Focus knows your positioning, and this is what he's abusing right now.
Focus just found a Tomb of Experience, level 3 on the Torrent Chieftain. Here he comes, enough mana for the wave. Here's the first one, hitting pretty well. The Tinker isn't problems. Heal Scroll being used immediately. The Ensnare is working good for him as well. Mass Cyclone coming in, several preservation saving the third tier, but he needs him because the Pocket Factory is down and he needs another one. One more Shockwave on the Torrent Chieftain. There's a Heal Scroll as well. All the talents, okay, they are being split now. Lolliot is doing this so good. Here comes the wave, but only hitting 3 talents. That's not the perfect outcome, but of course, the Raiders are taking care. 3 talents down, 4 talents, 4th talent about to die, and there's not too much that Lolliot can do it at can do against it at the moment.
Yeah, he's not bringing back his Tinker. For some reason, he's not paying attention to it. Now it leaves both of the heroes kind of exposed, and he will be forced to use the Town Portal sooner or later. Demon Hunter pops an Invo Potion, will try to kill like a few more units, or maybe the TC, but I don't think that he will succeed in killing the TC. The plus 22 damage on that hero is pretty much crazy. Demon Hunter slaying that Spirit Walker without any trouble, now retreating from the battleground here. Finally, we're gonna see the Tinker back in the fight, replenished by the Moonwells. Is there enough mana? There's no more mana on that Blade Master. He could definitely go for a snipe on that one if he really wants to. Now Focus is retreating from the Pocket Factory. TC not standing as strong as he would usually do. No expansion attempt for the Orc player, and he goes for that fight. Nonetheless, is going back into it. No more mana for a wave here, and I don't think that this is a good idea for the Orc player.
Me neither, but the Tinker, he might get him. There's Ensnare, so no staff, ending it in style. Splitting his head into, but the TC is also dead. Who gets the second kill here? Blade Master versus Demon Hunter. The plus 12 claws, they help so much. Level 4, and that's GG by Focus. Y'all said it. Is that the correct decision to stay in this fight? I didn't think so. Y'all didn't think so. Focus did think so, and he failed. I mean, we talk about this in the cast a lot. Night Elves have it a little easier because they can reproduce their talents so quick, so cheap, and the fight was closer to Lolliot's base than it was to Focus's base, so the reinforcements came a little faster for him. So that's the equalizer now, 2-2 between Focus and Lolliot.
Yeah, now we equaled the series and we're gonna jump into a best of three from now on. 2-2 for both of the players so far. I think Lolliot is doing a fairly better job, like judging the situation and knowing whenever he has to fight and can fight. The almost marine split like StarCraft 2 micro with the tail ends, that looked pretty damn cool, and microing it accordingly was pretty damn effective to split it. But at that time, I don't think there was like too much mana on the TC anyhow. Still, I like that he tries to go for it to dodge that bullet and not take too much damage on these units. But yeah, the plus 22 damage, the claws plus 12, that is definitely doing a great job on the Demon Hunter. And if you're not able to kill that one or force him out of the fight, I don't think that you can like take the fight any longer. Like, especially if you are so drained out on your TC, if you don't have any more heal scrolls or invo potion to keep that hero alive. So I don't really know why Focus decided to give it another try and run into that army.
Maybe he thought that he wouldn't have enough time to run away, because running away versus Cyclone, not that easy, but of course you have Endsnare on the other side. I don't know, it's a hard decision, but yeah, the Tauren Chieftain was very, very low on HP, so... yeah, I think it was not the best decision, otherwise you wouldn't have lost the game. Next map could be a little different, because there's one map in the map pool where a lot of the time the Night Elf players don't go for talents, and that is Twisted Meadows, and that's the map we're gonna see next.
Yeah, Twisted Meadows is kind of odd for Night Elf player against Orc, because Talents, they can work here, but most of the times Talents are not that powerful because the map is way too big. You can go for this grubby kind of style with the multiple bases, base race scenario with radius and stuff. So this is like actually preventing you from playing Talents sometimes. Still, a lot of Night Elf players open up with Huntress Hall and follow it up with Talents. Or they go for this 1-1-1 build, one Ancient of Lore, one Ancient of Wind, one Ancient of War, with Huntress, Talents, Dryads, and an expansion on top of that, or even a Tavern Hero start that we saw from Moon that was not successful at all, but he still tried it, so it might be a strategy that could work if you played a little bit better or if you change it up a little. But so far, Loloid seems like the kind of guy that goes for the normal kind of build, and yes, it is the Altar of Elders. He's spawning at the 11 o'clock position, the red Night Elf player from South Korea who was able to equal the series to a 2-2 score, going up against Focus at the 1 o'clock position here on Twisted Meadows. Here, the yellow spawning Orc player, also from South Korea, is trying to get the title from Loliad, who was able to win it in the first season. And the Ancient of War is kinda offensive here, going for that mercenary camp. If Focus finds out about that, I think he can punish him quite heavily right off the start.
That's exactly correct, and I think if he scouts counterclockwise, then there's a high chance of him scouting that, because he knows, of course, if the Night Elf is, I don't know, a little cocky, he goes for that, and he will definitely scout that, because he saw Laliad's shenanigans with a Zappa, who failed to explode, but yeah, with cluster rockets first and stuff. So he will go for that, and Laliad not opening up with a Huntress build, as we saw from the older Night Elf players from Korea, like Remind, like Moon. They all do it. I guess the European Night Elves do it as well, but I'm not so sure about this. But yeah, this is Archers here, so it might result in Talents as well, but we'll see about that. Of course we have the Blade Master, of course we have the Demon Hunter, and it's all about the scout now. Player's forces
are under attack. Like the pull here. Guys, if you're a Night Elf player, definitely do that yourself. You pull away, like, almost the entire camp beside that Rock Golem, he will go on that Ancient of War, and this gives you a little bit of an edge in terms of creeping. Usually the guy sticks there and you can attack him through the entire time. This makes it a little bit easier. I also think that Loliad is quite familiar with the style of Focus. He knows that he really likes his creeping early on with the Blade Master, sacrificing the second burrow for early attack, and that kind of is not allowing you for any kind of, what is it called, like scouting. But he on the other side is not wasting any time. He goes for the level 6 Troll Warlord here. It's opening up with that. Even though I think the other one is a better spot to creep here, the mercenary camp.
I think so too. Usually you go for that shop creep. Oh, Focus has to be so careful, man. It's getting close. Belt of Giant Strength, a little more HP, but not really worth the effort. Usually you start that shop creep just for the tome, to gamble for a tome of experience and get a head start. But not this time. He went for the item immediately. Level 1.5 already, but on the other side you see the Demon Hunter with a big heal potion and the level 2.
This opening is so bad on so many levels, because you creep that, of course, you get that XP and the item, but he delayed his shop so far, like, I don't know, he was stacking, he prefers to have that super early tech, and now he's running around with 100 HP, even his grunt is a little bit damaged. If the Demon Hunter really decides to go for it, he can kill the only grunt that's on the field. I even don't like the base layout, because you can enter it from pretty much everywhere. So I cannot really think of a worst start for Focus here. The item not that great. super low HP Blade Master. If the Demon Hunter gets the boots and dust, he can just chase him down and just prevent him from healing. He's now idling at his shop trying to force these peons to kill something or force them into the Boros to actually get the mining or deny the lumber harvesting here. He's dropping down the items. The troll is real. Stealing that forest troll Berserker. Speaking of trolls, for focus here from the mercenary camp of Loliath. But so far, I think Loliath is in a way better position than his orc opponent.
Yeah, I would agree. Battle for the boots. And who gets it? It's the Night Elf this time. Being detected immediately, so he knows where he's heading. But the shop is ready for focus, so he can buy heal selves. He bought a Troll Berserker very early on to help him in this defense. The tech is almost finished, though. And then, yeah, let's see what he does with it. Maybe Mass Raiders?
Look at the Demon Hunter. He's standing strong and he's just going ham on that orc unit. Blade Master low, Grunt low. Now dropping the potion down on the ground, trolling his opponent even harder. Now forcing that Blade Master maybe to use a potion on his side as well. He will have to sacrifice 150 gold if he wants to go for it. It's like a very odd game to say the least.
Yeah, definitely. But of course he can stay in there. He can apply some pressure. But now he says, okay, if you don't want this battle, I will keep my Potion of Greater Healing for later. And his tier 2 tech almost finished as well, but the question remains, what will Focus do with it? It is a Torrent Chieftain and a Lodge. So I'm not too sure why that early tech seems to be... Yeah, no Beastry just yet. There it is. Pretty late, but of course still faster than the Ancients of Wind for Loliath. But I guess we're going to see a hard push early tier 2.
Yeah, early push will be the cause of action here for the Orc player. But Beastmaster is coming here. Staff of Preservation is already bought. He cannot really afford it right now. I thought he bought it already because the gold was gone. But now he's throwing down two Ancient of Wind here inside his main base. Completely walled off with that shop. Tier 3 super fast. Ancient of War in position to actually creep the laboratory here. And he's getting his Beastmaster also back to that spot to creep it. Quillbeast is scouting on the Orc player, seeing that he's creeping. Solidite knows that the Blade Master is not around because he's creeping the orange cabin close to his main base. And this gives him the time to get a bigger creep spot down.
What did he get here at the Rock Golem? It is the Boots of Quel'Thalas! Plus 6 damage and armor and more attack speed. Basically the dream drop for the Demon Hunter. Focus in the meantime. He's going for the second shop. Still no level 3 Blade Master, but he got a Claws of Attack, which is pretty nice. He needs definitely a buff Blade Master. And yeah, we will see talents again, so the Torrent Chieftain definitely the correct choice. I don't know if he scouted it or just assumed it. Rune Brace is of course an item to sell since there's no single target damage or magic damage coming in from the Night Elf, except the talents of course, but that's ignorable, I guess. Level 2 on the TC, so he has the aura and decided to go for Shockwave now.
Yeah, Shockwave will be very useful here, but in the end, level 1 Shockwave only. Is he going to purchase every single mercenary unit there is as soon as he hits day? Because the Boro is about to finish, that might be a crucial time where he's just buying everything. That big Mauler and another Berserker, and this gives you a slight edge, I think, in terms of fighting units. Because a lot of DPS from that Forest Troll, as well as a nice unit right in your face of your opponent with that big Ogre. But he's not getting that Augur Warrior. Ancient of War also making it back to the main base of the Night Elf. I really like to see that one. Playing it a little bit more careful to have that building back and prevent you from falling to that push that is about to hit you. Blade Master got himself a nice healing scroll. So Lelight knew what was coming and he's prepared for it. So there's absolutely no chance for Focus to run inside that main base and kill him.
But he keeps him kind of stuck in his main base. He can't really creep. He knows, okay, I have to stick around in my main base just to be sure. And that's of course time that Focus can use. Ring of Regeneration is also a nice item to get some HP back after creeping. And this will be a level 3 Blade Master. And then he has level 2 Windwalk, more time on the Windwalk duration, so he can get more info on the scouts. And he can send them away to creep his level 2 Torrent Chieftain simultaneously. And I guess he didn't get that Mauler because of magic damage of Talons. It just adds up too much and it's not really worth it. But the Berserkers, of course, nice addition to the army of Focus. He likes to do that. Level 3 Demon Hunter in a short while as well, with the Orcs getting ready to attack.
Yeah, and this is a moment where Lolite has to be careful, and this is also the reason why he's going back inside that main base right now. I thought that I want to mention that he already got the Staff of Preservation to staff out a hero, but there's absolutely no Staff of Preservation on neither of the heroes. Kind of interesting to see that, because some Knight of players, they get the staff very late or not at all. Like back then, I remember Impact from my team at Hex, he was not buying it at all, and all of the people kind of blamed him for it. It's like, dude, why don't you buy that one? It's so good. But Lolite usually gets it. So far, he's not getting it. I don't know why. He got the money, he can definitely afford it. The Orb of Venom is already real on the Demon Hunter, so with the Boots of Kel'Thalas and that Circlet of Nobility, he gets plus 13 damage on him and the additional armor, so damage reduction is real as well. TC still level 2, now going for the second Mercenary Camp here on Twisted, and probably buying another Force Troll Berserker there.
Most likely. He is an upkeep already. 53 food for him. Big mana potion would be the dream. It's a big invul potion, which is also very, very good for the Blade Master. Usually you don't want to hang around in the air being cycloned, and the big potion helps you with that. But he has 3 Berserkers now. That is so much.
There's a Zeppa. Look in the main base of Focus. There's a Zeppa right now. Just hanging around and saying, here I am, and now detonating on 2 peons for them late.
I was a little late to that party, but yeah, he crushed them. I think damaging the burrows, I mean, they are so close together.
Yeah, you can actually, there's actually one thing that you can move in. There's like a small street that you can go to. But yeah, whatsoever. Now he has the Tome Portal inside his main base and prevent the push from succeeding. One Batrider for Focus is being sniped, even though it's absolutely no use because there's no Fairy Dragon yet. 47 supply for the Knight of Player, 58 supply for the Orc. This is the 10 supply that you usually need to overcome the Talons. They are close to the Moonwells, but so far the Raiders are streaming into the Talons. Pocket Factory being sniped, Demon Hunter has to be careful. Big Potion still on the hero, now finally using it. Tinker now in a little bit of trouble here. No more Staff of... Yeah, I said it, no Staff of Preservation, so he definitely has to be careful with his heroes when one of them is surrounded. There's no chance of getting that one out. And I think Focus might realize that because he's ensnaring the Demon Hunter. Tinker is juicing up at the Moonwell. One Moonwell remains, but the Tail is not standing really strong. It's trying to snipe a Raider that dies, but the nice wave connects on a few Talons. Do you think the Orc player is able to win that one right now?
Yeah, looking good. He's going for the Demon Hunter Critical Strike for 126, and he is kind of stuck there. Potion is on cooldown. He's chasing him with the Walkers. Oh my god. He's still alive. He's switching to the Tinker now. Once again, no Cyclone. All the Talons are dead, as it seems. Yes, Lolite heavily struggling. Lost his third hero, and the TC is still looking good with that Invul potion. He can swap it to the Blade Master to enable Beast Mode once again, but Focus is retreating. He sees, all right, I didn't lose too much, like 2 or 3 units, but I definitely need to heal up because Spirit Link was in full effect. Dispel now, so no more vision on the Orc units. He will go back, heal up, and then come back even stronger.
Too bad that they didn't buy a Zapper for the fight and detonate it on a few Raiders. That would have been lovely. I was just thinking to myself, have we ever seen cocky and trolley South Korean players? Like, you experience quite a lot, and we have seen quite a lot of games combined, but I think I've never seen trolley Korean players.
No.
This is something very new.
Yeah, it's true. Sometimes they do it, but not when it's in a final of a tournament, man. It's so much money on the line, and of course the title that you will carry around until season 3, or until season 3 ends. So there's definitely...
I don't want to kill the hype, but usually if you troll around like that, there's some kind of like deal involved.
Yeah, but it's also about pride and honor. And in the Asian community, that's worth a lot, I guess. So let's not overestimate it, I guess.
See, Kobe's canceling the Clarity Potion. Still 2 waves on that hero. Another Force Troll Berserker. Now up to 3 Berserkers again. Tinker still being revived. Should drop out of that altar soon. The level 2 Tinker is back to the battlegrounds. Is there Staff of Preservation finally? Nope, there's not. He's skipping out on that one completely. Mana burn on the TC would be actually legit before he gets the mana. Yep, 95 mana burned. No more wave. Demon Knight has to be careful. Critical Strike, 162. Tinker out of position with that evasion. He cannot keep that one alive. No Staff of Preservation. And Ensnare is keeping him in place. and this looks kind of good for focus, but on the other hand, being completely drained in terms of mana on that TC is not a good thing for you. Now level 4 for the cow, but still 2 heal scrolls to replenish the missing HP on the units, so I think he might commit to that and just force the issue.
I would totally agree. There's no items on the Night Elf heroes. The Tinker is once again being bought back. Of course, he was completely out of position. Very easy for Focus to pick up that third hero, but the Pocket Factory is still working for him, but not for much longer. So I guess he's just waiting for that. Yes, and now he might engage. Everything is green. Not only the skin of the units, but also the health bars. And he's going for the Altar of Elders. Will the Tinker come out? He definitely needs the damage from the Clockworks to fight against this, but okay, he will come out most likely, but will he lose the Demon Hunter in the process? There is one potion, using it now, mana burn once again, but the End Snares, they are too mighty, but he does escape this one. Lalight fighting or killing one Raider. TC now being surrounded. There's no Invo Potion, no Heal Scroll here. Dispel once again being used, the Demon Hunter saving himself to the Moonwell, so damn close. And I guess that's the end for you, my Torrent Chieftain friend. 100 HP missing. Can he swap something? No, he can't. But ends there on the demon. Holy cow. This is very, very close. No hit from the Blade Master. He's out of mana now. He might get surrounded. Focus might throw that game. But there's still lots of piercing damage against the Talon. Surround is not close. The Blade Master
the
can walk
real.
And
the
yeah, he's losing so many units, man.
Look at this three heroes killing everything alone. He doesn't even need the Talons. The Demon Hunter alone with the Tinker and the Beastmaster doing such a great job. Level 5 for the Blade Master. Maybe level 3 crit can turn the tides. But look at all the units. Look at all the damage. Even the trolls down to 50% HP. Now the last Walker, the last remaining one, is dying. And the expansion is already scouted by the Whisper most likely.
Yeah, exactly. He hung around that for such a long time. Level 4 on the Demon, level 3 on the Beastmaster, being very close to level 4. Tinker level 2.5. On the other side, he has to wait for such a long time for the Torrent Chieftain to come back. That's the perfect timing for Lalaya to attack. Maybe he will be the one getting the 3-2 lead in this series. And Focus, of course, he has that level 5 Blade Master, he has level 3 Critical Strike, but it's only plus 10 damage. I mean, it's good, but it's not perfect. And now, of course, he goes for the Orc Burrows. They're so easy to kill, you see the lots and lots of magic damage. 2 Burrows down, Focus is supply stuck.
Yeah, fighting in the Boros is definitely not the best choice, and he knows that. For that reason, he's retreating Mana Burn on that last remaining Spirit Walker, no more Dispel. For the Orcish race, TC is still not back in business. 75 to 80% done, about to pop out of that altar sooner or later. But the fight is breaking out in front of the main base here of the Orc player. He cannot fight in his Boros, and he has to fight with the few units that he got. He's using that Invo Potion on the Blade Master, trying to force the Demon Hunter here away or just kill that one. But the misses are coming out, the evasion is kicking in, and it's looking very, very grim here for Focus. Level 3 Tinker already, TC finally back. The cow might be able to hit a nice wave here, but not even succeeding in doing that. Is up in the air and is idling there, splitting the talons in all different directions, just waiting for the wave to hit just one unit in the end. The wave is hitting the Demon Hunter. Is he able to kill the first hero of the night? Of Blade Master is up in the air for the entire time. It's around on the TC again. Is it still open? Not sure. Nope, it's not open. Blade Master will try to kill the Demon Hunter here. Is the cow able to do it himself? Miss coming out, but kills it with the big axe right in there.
But he gets the revenge kill on the TC. No more mana on the Blade Master. Can he get him up and can he get him surrounded? That's the big question. No, he walks out again. Does he have the resources to get him from the tavern? No, none of those players have. But of course, it's still 44 food versus 21. Twice the supply for the Night Elf players. And with a Hawk, more magic damage. These Burrows will not stand one chance. TC is being revived. Counter expansion for Law Light and the Engine of War to harass the expansion here. So there's also some macro game going on, despite the fact that they fight for their lives here in the main base of Focus. Blade Master back on the earth, but no, once again, no more Burrows for the Orc.
Actually, one more Burrow in two of the main buildings, but no one would to actually throw down more buildings or build anything, even though he got the gold from the two gold mines that he's mining from. The TC is revived, you said it, but the Blade Master, he cannot deal damage because he's up in the air for the entire time. And yeah, by denying him the DPS from that hero, he's basically denying himself in that game, and there's no chance that he's killing anything beside that Kulbis that he leaves him in the base. So level 5.5 Blade Master, but focus. I would really like to know what he's writing right now.
Yeah,
but
me too.
Maybe I think he might Blue be Tail kind can... of pissed about this game.
Maybe Blue Tail can translate for us, but yeah. The expansion is under pressure. Can he somehow come back? There's no more mana on the Talons. It's time to pick up the pieces here. First Talon down. Second Talon about to die. He wants level 6, of course. 250 critical strike. The damage is huge, but he needs invul potions and a lot of dispel. The expo is down now. No more peons gathering gold, and the expo for Lolliot is up and running.
A player's forces are under attack.
Yeah, to be honest, I think Night Elf might be the only race that can actually troll and still win a game in a legit way. We even see Chimera, who's being started here from Lolliot, Blademaster toying around. He knows that he is in a very bad position here on Twisted Meadows, most likely not able to win the game. On top of that, Lolliot was able to get the expansion, you mentioned it, in the meantime. And yeah, he will get Chimeras, but Focus is not willing to lose to Chimeras, and he's calling GG. And for the first time of today, we're gonna have Lolliot in the lead.
Very, very, very good performance by the Korean Night Elf, man. Having a 1-0 advantage is always hard. Then losing the first map of this final, being down 0-2, and then win 3 games in a row, having match points now, that shows you how strong the mind of Lolliot is.
Ah, very odd game to say the least. Like using the Zapper to detonate two peons and trolling around, not using the Staff of Preservation at all and still winning that game, it makes me kind of worry about someone who plays like the Thryhard Night Elf and is just destroying orc players left, right, and center. Not good, guys. That's really not so good. But Focus should be able to come back from that.
I think so. I really want to see the 7th map here in this one, but first we have the next map is Secret Valley. So, of course, this is the Orc map, and this is definitely Focus's map to take.
Yeah. If there's one map in the pool that you are supposed to win, it's definitely Secret Valley as an Orc player. But yeah. Also, everybody's kind of familiar what Orc is doing on that map, so if you know some kind of a counter or crazy strat that you want to mix in, maybe Secret Valley might be the terrain where you want to play that as a Night Elf player, because this is not a map that you are supposed to win. Why not do something crazy like Ancient Protector Rush, like hidden Ancient Protector on the left side of your main base or the right side where the creep spot is. You can build a few Ancient Protector there and start walking on tier 2, and then you're gonna hit him and deny him to get access to tier 2 buildings, or just try to kill a Borrow or two and then set up bears at home. We've seen that in the past. Not sure why nobody is using it, because I don't see Orc players scout for it anymore. So if you go for the hidden protectors, it might work.
Yeah, very interesting. Would be a way to end this final in style. But I guess it's too much on the line here for such shenanigans. But maybe he wants to force the 7th map as well. We will see. The game does not start. Focus on the line. Still chatting. Bluetail says Focus is blaming balance for map number 5.
Yeah.
So the usual really... Night Elf Imbar chatter.
There's really some issue going on there with that race. There's a lot of stuff that we have to patch. I hope they pay attention not only to the Chinese, but also to some guy that is called Focus and that they might listen to in terms of the balance patch. But let's introduce the players again. It's the 6th map of the day. It's the match ball for Lolliot. But we're gonna introduce his opponent, Focus, the one who's challenging here, the one who came from the winner bracket and is now down one map and still has to take 2 in order to win that grand final. He's the yellow spawning orc player on the top half here of Secret Valley. His opponent, Lolliot, the defender of the title, able to win that one if he's able to win this game here and goes for the consecutive title in a row. That would be something very cool to have on his belt. Opens up with the Altar of Elders and that Ancient of War very close to the creep spot.
Yeah, but somehow it's working. The aggro for the creep kind of, I don't know, screwed up. But yeah, in the current Warcraft scene, it's actually a good point. We rarely see people defending their championship because the top of the scene is so stacked that almost everybody can win against everybody on good days. And so a performance like that would be something very special for Lolliot.
Yeah, absolutely. Also in the bigger picture, like having such a constant skill level and just showing that you can perform on the very highest level against the top South Korean elite players that tend to be the best players of the world sometimes. Not competing against the Chinese necessarily on WCA ground, but for all the Jarrah Cup that we see, we also saw a lot of Korean players coming back to the Jarrah Cup, dominating that quite a lot. Now Foggy back in the driving seat, actually taking the best of five final there against Focus. Maybe this was already an indicator that Lulayet might be in a good spot. Also, like, just giving away a few replays that Lulayet can study from Foggy, even though he doesn't really need to do that. But I think it's always great to have some replays, up-to-date replays, to see what your opponent is trying to play. And yeah, let's see how this unfolds. The one borrow tech yet again, not mixing in any crazy strats, not mixing in any different openings. He just likes to stick to whatever works. And so far, it's not working all that well. Let's see how he can pull it off in Secret Valley.
Exactly. It worked on Last Refuge, but not on the other three maps. But they were mostly bigger, except Ancient Isles. But this is a map that is pretty similar to Ancient Isles, I guess. But let's see. Focus, of course, starting things with an Ogre Magi creep, and I think he's pretty safe with that, getting the high damage outputs, so he can escape with ease from that. Well of mana stealing, that was not the desired item that he wanted to have. But he can sell it, of course, and the Demon Hunter after this null level 2 as well. So evasion works, or mana burn, finally. So this is the one specialty about Secret Valley. There's Fountains of Health, and that is always good for orcs, since it heals percentage-wise and not a fixed amount of HP per second. And since the orcs do have a huge XP HP pool, that they benefit a lot from them. If you compare it to the archers, well, you can do the math yourself.
That's true. This is the big bonus that orc players get from the healing fountains nowadays here on Secret Valley. And this is why everybody is actually vetoing Secret or Nomad Ides if you play these maps against orc. They might have an edge. Also, Echolites is one of the famous maps that Neo likes to get into, because there's something that keeps some people alive in that game, and this is the shop control. And speaking of the shop control, there we see the Boots of Speed Ferrari mode kicking in for the Blade Master, running to the fountain on the other side, most likely trying to creep that little guy there that drops the item. But the Demon Hunter is already on the chase with one circlet and two circlet on the Blade Master, so he definitely got the better end of that. 300 mana still on him, getting mana burned right now. This gives him the opportunity to kill the creep without mana burning him, the Gnoll Warden. This one is dropping the item. Now Lulayet is going for it. Is Lulayet able to kill that one?
Yes.
The experience goes to the Night Elf, right?
Yeah, but the item went towards the Blade Master, and he has three circlets now, which is basically the perfect opening when it comes to item drops. Focus once again with a very early tier 2 tech. He is finished already. Lulayet slightly after. But he's getting ready for the mid game with a shop, and this time maybe a stab. Focus continues to creep, just the item carrying creeps here. This time pair of fatality. But he gathers a lot of stuff in his inventory. A little messy, Focus is.
A little messy, yeah. He's super stacked, to be honest. Still level 1, so no crit. But there is the Blade Master with boots against the Demon Hunter without boots. Of course, the bigger healing potion has to be used from that spot. Is he really forcing the issue? No, he's not. This time he will not try to run to his moon worlds. That would have been too crazy.
Of course, that Wisp here scouted it before. And Focus says... he can't attack it because of this little lumber piece here.
Yeah, there's like this floating lumber.
Damn. He wanted to punish that Wisp for the scout, but wasn't possible. So Beastmaster is out. He continues to creep here again, not going for the tier 2 buildings. I guess he would have been too late anyhow. Maybe he could have gotten into the burrows, but that's out of the equation for now. More creeping with the help of the Engine of War. Focus on the other side once again with a Torrent Chieftain. Trying to get more items, trying to get more experience, and this is level 2 Blademaster.
Yep, level 2 Blade Master indeed. Critical Strike finally there, but in the meantime, Lulayet creeping one of the bigger cannons this time. Staff of Perturbation on the Demon Hunter already closing in on the level 3, not taking any damage from creeping that spot, securing himself a nice amount of XP as well as that Parry Up of Vitality. That is a great item that increases your HP by 150, basically a potion of healing that you get for the entire time, the entire game, if you don't sell it. And there, on the other hand, Focus is creeping the rest of that Goblin Merchant. Not really sure why he's going for that, because this is the camp that he crept earlier when he was like stealing the item from that camp. So why would you finish that camp off instead of creeping something like the orange spot close to your main base right away?
Well, if you want to go for an item, I can see why, but he didn't, so I'm not too sure. Now Lalight is going for the red drake. It takes some time, of course, since there's no Orb of Venom. The Blade Master is here, killing off that archer with a critical strike, followed up by the backstab. And yeah, he gets creep checked here now. I think the red drake will not die to the Night Elf. Almost the surround of the Demon Hunter. Had to be very, very careful of that. But he gets the Warden, and that is level 2 on the Beastmaster.
Yeah, Night Elf player does not even care that the Orc player is around. He's finishing the creep spot. Level 2 for the Beastmaster, level 3 for the TC, level 3 for the Demon Hunter. He can still Shadow Melt if he wants to and step out the Beastmaster. So there's absolutely no chance of killing that hero. So far, he's not even using that Shadow Melt. Now, finally using it, gave the staff to the Beastmaster, which is kind of dangerous because maybe he's now losing that hero. Beastmaster being surrounded. There's still an opening. And now the Beastmaster is finally off the grid. He cannot reach him anymore. He cannot staff him out. He had to use the Town Hall if he wanted to keep him alive, but this time he is going to die and he has to pay the price. He will lose that level 2 Beastmaster right now.
Was there an end snare? No, surround on the Raider, so he blocks him kind of, so he's not getting the net onto the Demon Hunter. So the first hero escapes, at least for the Light. This is a good comeback for Focus into that series. But the Orc player gets the Red Drake now with the help of Ensnare. But where is it? Struggle to see it. So whatever. Tinker third hero. Items on Focus is an Invo Potion this time and a Hero Scroll, so he gets both of it. Is he still waiting for the Ensnare cooldown, or did he just forget it?
The problem is you cannot really creep that Dread Drake with like two Raiders, cause you ensnare it and then it goes up again, and then you ensnare it, then it goes up again, and then you can actually almost heal up the damage that you dealt. You need like 3 to 4 Raiders to finish that one off, or you need some Spirit Walkers to attack it in the meantime. It would take too much time to actually finish that one. Now he's going for a shop that's supposed to have an item, but Lulayet stole that one earlier, the Greater Healing. And he should have been aware of that because he creeped at him there. Now pulling the workers again, getting a healing scroll as well as an invo potion on that Blade Master. Probably another healing scroll on the level 2 TC. Not even going for the level 3 creep. So the metagame changed here. There's an... Usually we had like TC creeping to level 3 and then maybe engaging in a fight. But Focus and Fly were proving themselves in the regard that you can actually take fights with a level 2 TC and just escalate from there. Just kill enough units. Maybe set up an expansion at some point, or just take the better traits in the fights and you are okay. But yeah, I don't really know how it works, because whenever I try it, everything dies and the Night Elf player can just get more and more units. But these guys really figured it out.
Oh, he uses an Ensnare now on the Wisp being detonated, of course, catching all the walkers as well. So there's not too much dispel going on for the Orc. We have Master Training for Lalayet. He has his 3 heroes back, and he was creeping a little spot, so 3, 2, 1 heroes. But finally, we see the level 3 Blade Master this time. He gets the Drake, and this can spawn the Vamp Aura, which would, of course, be the biggest thing for the Orc player, since everything basically is melee. It's the Boots of Quel'Thalas, which is awesome for the Blade Master. Plus 6 damage and more attack speed. So he will be at plus 16 or plus 10.
Night Elf probably racing for the Boros again, and there's no Town Portal on Focus. He's going for the red spot now. No, he's actually not racing for the base. I thought he might go for the base and kill a few Boros, since there is no Town Portal on that TC or the Blade Master. I think that might be the perfect move now.
Yeah, he has plenty of time. Does he have a Town Portal on his own? Yes, he has one on the Beastmaster. But it looks like we will see a fight in no time. Demon Hunter is level 3, so the mana burns really, really hurt. But, okay, now I think he's listening to you, and he's going for the Boros. They are pretty exposed, except especially the two right in front of here.
Yeah, he can definitely snipe the two. Yeah, these ones are in a very bad spot next to each other, cannot really be repaired. And against the Talent magic damage against for the heavy armor for the Boros, they are just melting. Look at the damage. He got 50 supply Talents, and this is so strong against Boros. You can just imagine. It's the same like a Grunt that gets sniped up there. Tree of Life at the natural expansion for Lulayet here. Red spot was not crapped by the Orc player. Is the TC level 3? Yes, he got the level 3. The Raiders are streaming in Ensnares on the Demon Hunter to keep him out of position to use that mana burn on the TC. TC is still trying to find a good position. Is he able to wave inside the Talents here? Talents are being split in two groups here, and the fight breaks out close to the main base of the Orc player.
Still no mana burn. Finally it hits him, so only one wave left, but we have to see it here. Oh, I killed two of them, and the third one being finished by the Blade Master, but I think the potential was there to hit a lot more. Talents is going for the Demon Hunter now. No potion on him, but there is the Step of Preservation once again. But the Raiders, look at the siege damage, just killing one Talent after another. This looks good for the Orc, but he lost a bit. He rebuilt his Orc Burrows, so he can produce again. The Night Elf, you mentioned it, puts up the expansion. Has to be scouted by a focus, or else the game that he has in his hands at the moment can slip through the fingers.
Yeah, I really hope that Focus gets the good read on his opponent, and it seems that way. He will creep jab him at the red spot, but he's not starting it yet. Lolight also waiting for the Orc player to come, but the creep cam gets activated here by the Blade Master, and now the Augur Lord is coming from the other side. Is he actually waving inside the Talons? Nope, the wave is not being triggered here, but the Orc player has to retreat, and there is the beautiful wave from the Tauren Chieftain inside all the Talons. No heal scrolls for the Night of Player, level 2 for the Tinker. Blade Master using that Invo Potion, still a heal scroll for him to keep the units alive, and Lolight is going yet again for the snipe on the Spirit Walkers, able to snipe two of them already. Two still alive, one of them red HP, the other one out of position right now within the Talons. The heroes are still in the air, as well as a few raiders. More Talons coming to the party, but in the meantime, he's losing unit after unit.
Exactly, man. The Talons, they're just dying like flies. 39 food for Lolight. Now he switches to the heroes, 100 critical strike, but the staff saves the Tinker for the second time. So Beastmaster and Demon Hunter kind of alone here, and for how long, we will answer that now. Critical strike again, and snare again, no staff at the moment, but the town portal saving him now. And he bought the time for the expansion, so the expo is up. It's not running yet. We don't see wisps approaching, but what we do see approaching is 5 raiders, and that will hurt a lot.
Yeah, the Orc train is real choop-choop, running for the expansion, trying to snipe that one in no time with the siege damage and that nice endurance aura. They hit like a truck, and you can see how fast that Tree of Life is actually melting away. He has to use the speed scroll as soon as he's done killing that building and retreat to the health fountain and regenerate there, because I don't think that the Night of Player can take a fight at that health fountain. But the Blade Master has to be careful. There's no more Invo Potion, no more Town Portal. If he gets surrounded there, he's in so much trouble. Same for the TC. If one of the heroes gets actually sniped, I don't think that the Orc player can any longer stay in that game. And this is the match ball game for Lolight. Is he able to take the game? Then he is able to take the title again.
Oh, the Demon Hunter looking good against the Tauren Chieftain, but he micros him away towards the fountain. In the meantime, the Raiders once again killing the Talents, at least one of them. But triple hero from the Night Elf looking fairly strong at the moment. Focus is dwindling. His HP is getting lower and lower and lower. Finally, he finds the Fount of Health, and finally, he has the time to recover. But for how long is the question? He immediately engages the Demon Hunter, or at least keeps him away from his army. He might be thinking that Talents are too strong, but he goes for the Tinker. He's blocked. He's blocking himself, and on the other side, there are Raiders waiting. They're just walking into the arms of the Raiders. Still not sure if that's the correct time. Answer here for Lolight. No, it's not. Everything is trapped. The Tinker is down. And the TC hits level 4. This looking so good for Focus.
And this is the reason why you should never take a fight against an Orc player at a health fountain. The Raiders were regenerating the HP like crazy. 600 HP compared to the 380 HP we have on the Talon. This is quite some healing done by that fountain. And yeah, you can see it. He's paying the price for that now. He's losing so many units. He lost the Tinker, not even reviving that one. He's getting back a lot of the Talents here in Ball of the Ancient of Wind. Now going on the red spot creep here. Almost level 4 Demon Hunter, level 3 for his second hero, the Beastmaster. But level 4.5 for the Blade Master already. Linehorn of Stormwind as an aura here for him twice. So he will at least... Oh no, he just gave it over to the TC. Sorry for that. And the level 4 TC with the level 2 endurance are on top of that. Still 700 gold to spend to the account here of Focus. Of course, he needs to buy a lot of items here. Needs to get healing scrolls as well as invo potions. Now still got the 400 gold that he can spend sooner or later. But he's setting up an expansion. And is he going for a base race scenario here in that game? Researching the pillage yet.
I think he just wants to bag it up. I think he knows how far ahead he is in hero levels, and also regarding the items here, we have two heal scrolls, one invo potion. The hero levels are great for him, and Lalaya does not have the army to leave his base at the moment. 46 food for the night elf, 50 for focus. That might be a little greedy, because of course he doesn't want to pay taxes to the upkeep. But will this break his back in the end, man? The Wisp is coming. The Wisp is scouting the Great Hall. There's plenty of time to set up an Engine of War, so I guess that Stronghold will not finish.
Yeah, that's true. I think he will deny that one. And as soon as he spots it, he starts running. But first of all, he has to run to the shop to get one healing scroll or an invo potion. No town portal this time for the Night Elf player. And I think we haven't really spoken about it, but the red drop for the Demon Hunter was a plus 12 claw. So plus 24 damage for the Night Elf first hero again.
That is so nuts, man. He found all the right items so far. And of course, Focus saw that. The Quill Beast trying to take down the Great Hall. There's no Engine of War, no Entry Protector, of course, because there's no Huntress Hall. Focus knows, all right, I have to defend now. That means I have to invest. He's breaking upkeep, securing that second gold mine. How far along are the main gold mines? 2,190 is still in there. On the other side, we see an Invo Potion on the Demon Hunter and a heal scroll on the Beastmaster. So it's kinda even, but of course the Orc heroes will hurt a lot more.
Yeah, but the Talons, look at the mana. Just check them, like, randomly. All of them close to 300 mana and more. Some of them almost full mana. We're gonna see Cyclones like there's no tomorrow. We also see a little bit of Dispel on the side of the Orc player, but if he's able to snipe these Spirit Walkers, I think he might be in so much trouble, even though his army composition looks very strong here. But yeah, let's see about that. The fight is about to break out. Take over, Neo.
Okay, Pocket Factory immediately being killed. But the first Invo Potion has been used, so a lot of Cyclones coming towards that Blade Master. Can he kill the Tinker before that? You see stormy times here on Secret Valley. Everything is high up in the air, except the Tinker may... He might go 6 feet under, but no, not yet. Oh my god, I have to change the camera angle, man. It's, everything is in my way. And he does snipe the walkers. It's looking good. The first shockwave hit, but not too hard. The magic damage is too much, man. He can't kill the orcish casters for now. But now the raiders are applying to the talons, and they do so much damage.
Yeah, and I think he's losing way too many talons while the fight continues to break out here, and the expansion is done, but only one worker is mining. So far the fight is quite good for both of the players. They are killing huge chunk of both armies. The walkers are dwindling, only one worker remains, two of the fairy dragons still in the air. TC tries to stand strong, still a mana potion on him. Can he use that one and use it good on the talons? Has to be careful, he's almost losing the TC here. Spirit Link not keeping him alive. Is there a heal scroll on the Blade Master? No, it's not. The second hero from the Orc player is dead again, and they're not hitting in time. And the Demon Hunter gets stepped out.
He needs the MVP, he needs his Blade Master, killing three talents at the row, and the raiders are still strong. It's on the edge this game. Level 4 and level 2 on the Night Elf heroes, but the Tinker this time, I think he will go down. Looks like no mana anymore on the talents because nothing is flying. He loses so much mana. This is it. Level tier 3 Tinker is down, level 2, and he gets the Beastmaster as well. Where is the Demon Hunter? Where is the rescue?
No more rescue for him. There is still a Staff of Elevation on that second hero. But the Blade Master going to town. 228 critical strike on the Beast Master. He has to give the staff over to the Demon Hunter. But the Demon Hunter is kept in position. Nowhere in snare on the second hero of the Night of Player yet again. Is he able to keep that one alive? If so, he might be able to take that game. The level 2 Hawk is going to town. The Thunder Hawk is doing so much damage.
Such an awesome, awesome battle by both players, actually. So the question now, where is the Torrent Chieftain? Two-thirds revived, I guess. The expo for Focus is running, and for the longest part in this game, it looked like, oh, this is easy win for Focus, but no. Lalaya fighting like a lion. He won't give up this game. He keeps his heroes alive, except the Tinker. He needs units, he needs items, and his main gold mine is about to collapse. Only 250 gold remaining. Same, of course, goes for the Orc, but he has a backup plan. That is his Great Hall here. But for how long is another question, because the Demon Hunter is coming in.
Yeah, he needs to delay the fight. I think he needs the TC in the next fight that is about to break out at the expansion. He should have just took a few workers and sent them back to the main base until that hero comes back to the fight. Look at the amount of Talons now. He just lost the entire his entire forces, and now they're all back. Level 6 for the Blade Master, maybe a Blade Storm sooner or later, but we don't see the amount of mana that he would actually need for that right now. So he has to go back to his main base, has to get a mana potion to maybe do it. TC, is the TC back? Yes, he's coming. He got the mana potion in his inventory. He's giving it over to the Blade Master. We're gonna see a Blade Storm soon. Do we see this Crow Dodge? There it is, the Blade Storm, the Crow Dodge. It's real. Oh, it's happening.
Yeah, a lot of mana wasted, as you can say. But no, he gets the Hero Beastmaster down. No chance. Level 5 on the Torrent Chieftain. Finally, the Blade Master high up in the air. But he gets the hero kill on the Demon Hunter, most likely. Where are the Ants Nest? There it is. Where are the Dispels? They're nowhere because there are no walkers. And so the Demon Hunter can escape for the second time. Invo Potion being used now. Ants Nest being thrown. Misses! So many misses! Are you kidding me? But he gets it in the end. There were like 4 misses in a row. What the hell? But Focus takes it home, equalizes this series, and $1,750 will be given away for winning one map.
Yeah, it all comes down to one map. We go the whole distance here, and what a sick game we just saw here on Secret Valley. Seriously, the misses in the end, like, hit after hit got missed. Like, don't tell me to sell the Talisman of Evasion anymore. This is the best item, especially against the Blade Master. If you can dodge the bullet over and over and over again, you might be able to win the game. In the end, it was not enough. But going for the last remaining map here, I'm looking forward to it.
It's going to be so epic, man. 3 misses in a row, and I bet my ass there was a critical strike involved in that one. The map has been hosted, and the last map of today is Tirina Stand is a good Night Elf map. But also, you can create chokes, you can create narrow positions, and if you keep your Torrent Chieftain safe from the mana burns, those waves can hit so hard.
Yeah, the waves are pretty good here on that map, but usually I would think Tirina Stand is quite a good map for Night Elf. Of course, you start off level 2, you have the access to a shop right next to your main base, you have that natural expansion super far away from your opponent with the bridges that you can easily fight on with Talons. I really don't know. I think it's a great map for Night Elf, but maybe Focus can pull it off and win here with his splendid control and maybe not losing his TC like over and over again, because we have seen multiple maps where he loses his second hero without an invo potion on him and playing a little bit sloppy in that regard. But on the other hand, with the incredible micro of the Raiders killing off the entire army while he's losing a few units in return, the exchanges were so good for him.
Yoss, my friend, we have covered this tournament for so many weeks now. Every Thursday we had this date. Well, 12 o'clock CET, alright, I'll be there. This all ends now. This journey, this TWCL2 journey, it ends here. It ends on Tirina Stand. So one last time, let's introduce the players. On the upper left is the Night Elf player, who is slightly favored by the map, but not inexperienced, because he faces Focus, a guy who has been around since 2005 or something. Multiple WC3L winner, bronze medalist of WCG, and of course one of the strongest Korean orcs that we have seen in a while. This is old school versus new school, 26-year-old Focus in the bottom right.
That's true. It's going to be the last game. We're going to see a normal opening for both of the players. Engine of War close to the laboratory creep spot, and only Focus can pull it off. The one borrow tech that works so good from his point of view. And yeah, so far we still see the very same stuff here. Blade Master coming out, Demon Hunter on the other side, and the Archer will be started in a short period of time. And yeah, I'm a little bit nervous, and I hope we're going to see a good game and not some kind of a trashy game that ends after 7 to 8 minutes.
Have you played a best of 7 series yourself?
I cannot really recall. Like, back then I remember practicing best of 11.
Wow.
Like, when I was practicing custom games with people, we were like, okay, every day we're gonna do a best of 11 against this guy, or best of 11 against this guy. So this was my practice schedule back then, when I was still hitting it hard by the age of 19 or 18. But yeah, ever since that, I cannot really recall any best of 7 series that I have played in a competitive match, so absolutely no.
So Do you get tired of playing the same matchup, the same opponent over and over again when it's so close? The player's forces are under attack. Or is it just the adrenaline that keeps you on point?
Yeah, it's somewhat the adrenaline, but it's also the practice schedule for these guys. I think Focus was one of the guys who practiced like 12 hours a day, and some people got really crazy about it. But on the other hand, we also saw like Todd the other day, one of the old school players, the old school human legend, and he was hitting the ladder for like, I don't know, 10 to 12 hours. And people in chat were already like, dude, he's practicing like crazy. But yeah, this was kind of normal back in the day. But to pay attention to the game, Lolai just denied the big renegade wizard with his Ancient of War, denying himself the experience for that. And this is definitely a start that you don't want to have.
Definitely. That is not level 2 for the Demon Hunter after this creep spot. He gets the Ring of Protection and Mantle of Intelligence. Also not the best items. He wants, of course, damage. He wants claws, circlet, and the slippers. He got none of it. On the other side, Blade Master only getting a little experience here, but he has the same items actually. So, no advantage here. But what we didn't see on Secret Valley, what we do see here is Mercenary Camp. So, Focus can once again get the Berserkers and add damage to the Talons.
That's actually true, but on the other side, it can only be also be abused by the Knight of player to pull them out like European Knight of tend to do. But now we're gonna see a huge misplay coming in here from Loliath, losing that archer. The creep got also stolen by the Blade Master, close to level 2. That Ancient of War is dropping low. The creep spot is still attacking it by killing the Wisp. He gets level 2 for the Demon for the Blade Master here already. While the Demon Hunter is still level 1, he will be able to kill that Ancient of War. And this is not only not completing the wall off, this is leaving you vulnerable to any sort of attack that is hitting you at tier 2 with a lot of units that come to your door.
Exactly, we saw it on Twisted Meadows where Loliad pulled back his Ancient of War to help him in the first defense on tier 2 when the Orc is stronger, when you don't have Cyclone. So that is a huge, huge, huge opening game for Focus. He is one of the best Blade Master players around, and that was the perfect execution of a creep jack. Can he get a Sasquatch? Or will he focus on the Forest Troll? Yes, he keeps the Demon Hunter low, keeps him away from level 2. And if he could only see the XP bar of the Demon Hunter, he would know, alright, that's exactly the right decision to do.
And you know what the best part of the story is? He went for level 1 evasion again. There is absolutely no mana burn on that Demon Hunter. This is the reason why he's still full mana and not burning that Blade Master now. And he will get the Sasquatch on the side of the Night Elf player. And this is such big of a deal, denying the experience, keeping that Demon Hunter on level 1, now even baiting him on that creep, not giving it to him, the Boots of Speed on the Blade Master, so he can easy peasy retreat from that, heal up again, come back for another round, and the Demon Hunter still on the level 1 with the evasion first. I think Focus might be making fun of his opponent or just mocking him for that.
Exactly.
So TC started, Spirit Lodge started, and everything according to plan for Focus.
This early attack once again, will it pay off this time for the third time, for the fourth time in this series? Oh no, the third time, of course, the first, the 1-0 was a given. But also Lolite with a fast attack this time. The Beastmaster is out. This time he does not go for creeping. This time he goes for the aggressive. But will it work with only a level 1 Demon Hunter? I highly doubt it, but the base seems to be open. The grunts can enter there, not blocking. So there's an opportunity for Lolite to cancel the tier 2 blink. But now the block is real. Now the doormen are here, blocking the heroes out.
Yeah, the bouncers say you are not allowed to enter, and they keep them out of the base. There's no chance that he will cancel that Spirit Lodge, either the Beastery, but no more mana. Right now, one mana point is missing. If he only had a mana burn, he could have killed that first hero there from the Orc player, and now he finds himself in so much trouble. He is walled off. The bouncers keep them inside the club, and this is the moment where you are about to lose your town hall or both of the heroes. The bouncers keep them in. Say goodbye to both of them.
This
you are not going nowhere.
Is this the perfect game for Focus, man? His Blade Master is still alive with 20 HP. He wants to kill him with the Quill Beast, but no. The Orc Brothers are doing a great job, and he uses the wave to kill that one, and he survives with 19 HP. Got both heroes. Got so much experience from that one. Oh my god, Tauren Chieftain already level 1.5, Blade Master so close to level 3, and what does the Night Elf have at the moment? 15 food! There is nothing on the battlefield for the Night Elf at the moment.
Yeah, not even the Ancient of War in front of the main base. He can be glad that this Demon Hunter is still level 1, so he comes out fairly fast out of the Altar of Elders. But yeah, it's kind of triggering Focus as well. On the other hand, he will go for that main base as soon as he finishes off the mercenary camp. He most likely getting the additional units. You said it, the forest troll berserker is providing so much good damage to him. Is he only baiting it out or is he creeping it? I think he might be creeping it, but he will just bait out the creeps to have like a little bit of a better position on that creeps. But let's see about that. Is he going for it? Or is he just getting the berserker? I think he really wants the experience. The endurance aura is way too good.
Exactly. I think he just wants at least the Kobold Taskmaster for that consumable item. Big Invul would be the dream. Level 3 on the Blade Master, man. And he will have level 2 Tauren Chieftain afterwards for the aura, which is also a damage boost for the Blade Master. And the item is... Wen of Mana Stealing. All right. Not the greatest. But of course, Lord Lyot. He has to fight uphill now. And... I don't know, we saw crazy night of comebacks. We talked about the talents being cheap and being fast on the battlefield. But whoa. The hero levels
are... Can you really win against a married man in the very last game of a best of seven? it's actually like 2-1. If the waifu-chan is cheering for you, I don't think there's a chance of winning that. But let's see what Focus is able to do here in that game. The wave, the dodges... He dodged the end snare earlier with the crow form, so nice, but now he's forcing the issue.
The heroes have to carry for Lalayat now. He's pressed with his back against the wall. What can he do? Nice pickups for Focus once again, getting that Quilby's getting more experience. And of course, he has complete shop control now. There is no invul potion, no heal scroll, so he can't really get anything. More raiders are streaming in. 46 food for the orc, 28 for the night elves. His moon wilds, they look pretty damn good. So fighting into the Night Elf base might not be the best solution here. So what does Focus do? I steal every single important creep spot there is on this map for you.
Yeah, he's denying him so much experience points. And now with the nice aura here for the Forest Troll as well as for the Breaker Spirit Walkers, he gets a lot of damage done. Let's see Healing Scroll being used. But the Blade Master without a potion has to be very, very careful, dropping down to 70 HP. The last healing scroll was being used. There's still a speed scroll. Demon Hunter now has to be careful. It's the target here for the Orc player. But the Blade Master on the other hand being micro away. Still an invul potion on that Demon Hunter. Is he willing to pop that one or is he going to use the Town Ball? He's using it for 4 HP, keeping himself alive. Can he kill? Can he get the return kill on that hero? No, the Blade Master retreats with 11 HP. And now he uses the Town Ball in the very last second.
Holy shit, the clockwork trying to get the kill on the Blade Master, but no. Once again, the orc too strong in this fight, and Invul Potion plus Town Portal is another 500 gold that he can't invest at the moment. So every single factor of this game points towards a win of Focus, points towards a win of the newlywed. But we see more and more talent streaming in. This is what we've talked about. This is the benefit of playing talents. So he needs levels now. He needs level 3 Demon Hunter, he needs level 2 Beastmaster. Maybe then he can fight, but level 3.5 and almost level 3 on the TC. And of course, he spent a lot of time in the half of the map of his opponent, so all his creep spots are still there, and that makes it very, very easy to creep him up to 4.
Yeah, just look at the dots that usually mark the spots where you can find creeps. The side of Lalayat is completely crept, even though he was barely getting anything out of that. And the other side is still stacked, everything is still there. The natural expansion, the mercenary camp, even the laboratory. There are still some creeps that you can fall back to and get some more experience from. And I think Focus also knows that his opponent might be around creeping one of the bigger, one of the smaller spots that still remain on his side of the map, because he cannot really risk going for the mercenary camp. Now Focus even sending out a peon to check on his opponent, to see his pathing, see if he's coming his main base or the way of his main base. Level 1 Tinker, level 1 Beastmaster, and level 2 Demon Hunter. Not impressive at all.
Now let's see what the second big item is. Rope of the Magi plus 6 on the Tauren Chieftain. Look at this mana pool. 420 plus 9 intelligence. Good luck to burn that amount of mana with a level 2 Demon Hunter.
So crazy. A player's
forces are. He needs 9 mana burns to get him empty.
Just imagine if that Blade Master died like in the top half when they fight it there. That would have been such a big kill. Only a speed scroll to get away from that, and there were like Cyclone to keep units there stuck and kill them. Might have been the comeback scenario, the only one that Lulayat could have found himself into, but now the fight is about to break out here. 420 mana, you said it. He needs to do so many level 1 mana burns, and he's not even close on getting that Demon Hunter to level 3.
He has some items though. The shockwave can be countered by one heal scroll, and there's an invul potion as well. But for focus, it looks the same. Same amount of items. Oh no, two heal scrolls. It is this time. And the fight is about to ensue. The ensnares are flying, but the position is good for the night elf here, in between the forest and the house.
The nice house on the other side, with the people watching from the windows. What's going on? What the hell is this house anyhow?
Well, it's exciting times living in there.
Definitely one of the this is the Crypts of Warcraft. Crazy houses next to each other.
So the second
you see this very small house, this is definitely the coolest one in between that, like where the Wisp is located. Yeah, there's one of the smallest houses. This is mine.
Nah, you're the rich bitch of Warcraft.
I got the fucking tower next to it.
You built you built the big houses. So yeah, second Taskmaster went to focus again. This time it's the Scroll of the Beast. So not the best items, but he got both. He got so much experience and yeah, level 2.5 Demon Hunter without any orange spot left on the map that he can creep. And of course,
ever since I found out about the houses, I'm paying a lot of attention to every single house on the map. There's quite a lot of them. I never paid attention. It's so sick.
Well, it's valley.
You're gonna see the Troll Bad Riders are still alive. The expansion is set in play for focus, and it's about to be done. So he will be on two mines with 67 supply against the 59 supply coming in for Lolite. He got the Augur Mauler, 3 Fairy Dragons, and a fair amount of talents with quite some mana here. A lot of them got 400 out of 400, and we can see that this nice sentry ward got revealed by the Hawk. He's not willing to use his Bad Riders to deny the Hawk, which would be like horrible to spend gold on something that you summon. But yeah, on the other hand, if you can delay them or kill some of the Bad Riders, that would be very, very good. You want to split the Fairy Dragons as good as you can. Now setting up the fight here, getting everything that he needs, is using the first Bad Rider for one of the Fairy Dragons. The second one finds the connection, kills at least one Fairy Dragon, still two alive. Yeah, Lolite tries to find the best position for the very last fight that we're gonna see in that map here, most likely. Let's see what we're gonna see here. Mr. Neo, take over.
The first wave was not that impressive, but there's more to come. At least one of them. Another mana burn. He needs to do this over and over and over again. Invul potion on both first heroes. Cyclone being used. Now the position is okay for Lolite. I say the Mauler is down immediately. Here comes another shockwave. That one was better. And he gets the revenge kills on the Berserkers. He focuses them immediately. But the Talons, they won't survive that long. The Raiders are continue to chase them. Another shockwave hitting so much, man. It's incredible. Going for the hero kill now. He wants the Demon Hunter being close to level 3. That would be so huge. He escapes for now, but not for much longer. Cyclone now. But the Demon Hunter dies. Is this the victory? Is this $1,750 into Focus's pocket? The Raiders, they're just ripping the Talons apart. No chance. Level 5. Beastmaster in problems. Ensnares hitting him over and over. There's nothing in the inventory anymore. GG! And the new TWCL champion married on Saturday, and it is Focus.
Congratulations to our man Focus with the waifu charm to his pocket and a lot of money. The nice gift there from Lolaya to the wedding. Good job, bro. Definitely well deserved, playing a phenomenal game here, the very last one that was sick, also the Secret Valley game before that. Such a splendid game, so nice controls, and we're gonna see why Focus is probably the best orc we have in the world next to Fly. And what a series, a best of 7 again, the last match of that league. And yeah, it's all coming to an end. We had quite some fun with that league, and probably gonna have a third season sooner or later.
Yeah, I hope
but
so.
But this is it. Does it leave us with more Warcraft action to come, or
of course, man. We have so much Warcraft going on, but let's recap a bit this league that what we saw. I think we just sat here on a Thursday and said, okay, let's do this. So let's see what happens here. And then we had this game of Gyro with the Alchemist with Heal Spray, and all of a sudden we were so hooked into this league. And we had so much fun over and over. We saw epic undead mirrors between Belief and Lucifer. We saw Moon getting the third place in this tournament. So yeah, let's just show the outcome on Liquipedia. Of course, it hasn't been updated yet, but Moon getting the third place, the runner-up, is of course Law Light, saving himself $670, but the big one goes to Focus here. Oh boy, that was one tournament. I think we can say Moon is pretty much back, getting the third place here. But Focus, for the first time before this tournament, he had never beaten Law Light in a competitive game, and now twice in a row, 3-1, 4-3, definitely very, very impressive. What we also saw was Reprisal trying to change the Night Elf versus Human matchup on one base without breakers.
Yeah.
That was also very impressive.
So yeah, leaving a huge mark, actually, and also we had Emol Fan Sock playing this quite some time. Like, after that, every human player started that strat, and he actually changed the meta game a little bit, at least.
So if you missed one of those games, it's all up on YouTube. It's in one playlist, so you can watch it one after another. What's coming up in the next days? Tomorrow there's the NWL, and I got the matches for you right now. It's gonna be Yumiko versus WFZ tomorrow, as well as Law Light and Joshishi. So one human versus undead, one Night of Mirror. On Saturday we will be here with Focus versus Remind. And so in versus 120, so in another Orc versus Night Elf, and we just saw how strong Focus is, plus an Undead versus Orc, which is always a great matchup. Plus on top of that, we have your 2-2 tournament on your very own stream that you can still sign up for, I guess.
Yeah, that's actually true. We're going to have another 2-2 tournament. We had to move it to this week because next week is super stacked with the Rust Brain Cup number 4 hitting us. Is it actually number 4? I think it is, right?
Yeah, it is.
So we're going to have that one. WCA Chinese qualifier from you is also still live. So we're going to follow that one every Monday and Wednesday.
Exactly,
or?
Yes.
So this is also up still. The Chinese guy's fighting for the slot. There might be some interesting stuff coming on. I think he wants to do a video about the group situation for Group B or something. Because there might be some close matches coming in and battling for the last spot that will go from or advance from the group stages. Yeah, what else do we have beside that?
On Saturday, we also have the Crown of Kings tournament on Africa TV. We will not stream this here. We will stream it on Africa TV. You can find all the information about this on Reddit. It's a tournament for $500, and 4 Koreans are playing. So we have from Europe, Foggy, Cooper, Hawk, and Sonic fighting Law Light, Check, Focus, and Sock. So that's going to be good on the Saturday afternoon, and on Sunday, of course, we will be here for Jarrah Cup 57.
That's true. Besides that, if you want to hit my YouTube channel, there is going to be a Throwback Thursday today where we see the replays of the year for 2015, the contestants from W3 Arena. There's a sick game between Sonic and Fallen, and they played a crazy Night of Mirror. I've never seen a bug that can be triggered by Chemical Rage and Cyclone on top of that.
What?
Did you know that when you use Chemical Rage and you get Cyclone, you can run invulnerable and can hit your opponent while he cannot do shit against you?
What?
Yeah, no. Check out that replay that I casted. It's 44 minutes long, Night of Mirror, and it's triggering a bug where the Alchemist is running to your heroes and he's killing like 8 heroes in that game or more.
Holy shit, I will not miss that. Yas, thank you very much for joining me on this journey that has been TWCL. We found our winner, we had so much fun. Thank you all for tuning in.